Hey Wargamers, today I want to talk about the Tyrannofex in the new Tyranids Codex for 8th edition. It's a giant model, it's a fantastic model, it's the same kit that makes the Turvagon. And in the past it hasn't seen a whole lot of use just because of some pretty big weaknesses. But in 8th edition I think it's a very strong option, and we'll talk about why that is in a minute. Before we do though, I want to say thanks for watching. If you like this video, go ahead, hit the like button and the subscribe button. That way you don't miss any of my upcoming year reviews or battle reports. Let's get into it. So the Tyrannofex is a big guy. He has movement 6, weapon skill 4, toughness 8, wounds 14, 7 leadership with a 3-up save. And then when he is at full wounds, he has ballistic skill 4, strength 7 with 4 attacks. So, just like you would kind of expect for a big creature, he has a lot of wounds, high toughness, and a reasonable save. You know, in previous editions, having a 3-up save wasn't necessarily the most amazing thing, but in 8th edition, a 3-up save is pretty darn good. Very few things have a reliable 2-up save, so that 3-up save goes a long way. So, he has the option to either take an acid spray, a fleshbore hive, or a rupture cannon as his main weapons, and each of those have slightly different rules. The acid spray is 18 inches, heavy 2d6 flamer with minus 1 AP and d3 damage, so it automatically hits. On average, this weapon is going to put out about 7 minus 1 AP d3 damage hits, so about 14 damage worth of wounds coming out of it in a single volley at minus 1 AP, which is not bad. That's pretty darn good if you can implement it. Having that amount of firepower is really nice high strength, it's nothing to sneeze at if the Tyrannofex is at its full strength, at full wounds. Once it goes down to 7 wounds, it's at 6 strength, and at 3 wounds, it's at 5 strength, so this weapon becomes a lot less useful as the Tyrannofex loses wounds. The Fleshbore Hive, again, is 18-inch range. It is heavy 20, strength 5 shots, so it's like having 20 pulse rifles, or 10 pulse rifles, somewhere in between. Let's say 10 pulse carbines, there we go. So it's 20 strength 5, 1 damage shots. That's it. And, that's fairly good in terms of just putting out a lot of firepower. But in general, I think that type of shooting is A, better left to just like Termagants, or to things with twin-linked or, twin devourers. So Hive Tyrants, Carnifexes, those guys are going to be able to do a more reliable job, and generally a better job of putting down that high volume, high strength fire. And of course, devourers are higher strength than fleshbores hives are, so they're better in that way too. So really not a huge fan of the fleshbore hive, but the thing that I love the most out of this guy is the rupture cannon. That's his third weapon option. Range 48, heavy 3, strength 10, minus 3 AP, d6 damage. And that's really good. One of the big things that Tyranids lack is long range firepower in a lot of units. There's a few notable exceptions, of course, but the Tyrannofex is one of those few models that can actually touch units across the board. Having 48 inch range is awesome. Strength 10 is awesome. Minus 3 AP and then d6 damage. That's really reliable. That's like having That's better than a melta gun, right? That's way better than a melta gun. And so being able to dish out these high strength, high AP, high damage shots to vehicles across the board, things like Titans, things like tanks, high priority targets like, Primarchs, things like that, that you're able to actually do some damage to before they become too much of a threat to you, is really important. So the versatility and the tactical options that having this high strength, high range weapon gives you, I think, is really valuable, especially when we consider his special rules. So he has instinctive behavior, of course, so you're going to want to kind of keep a synapse creature relatively close. It doesn't have to be super close because he's a single model, so he doesn't really have to worry about, well, he doesn't have to worry about morale at all. You just want to have him there so that he can shoot at different targets easily. He has a biotank special rule. This model does not suffer the penalty to its hits roll for moving and firing heavy weapons. Good, because if we were, you know, we want him to be able to move, basically. Weapon Beast, if this model does not move in your movement phase, it can shoot all of its weapons twice in your shooting phase. And that's the kicker. That's the thing that really makes the Tyrannofex and also the Exocrine very good, is that if he doesn't move, he fires twice. So that acid spray, instead of getting 7 hits, we're getting 14 hits. The rupture cannon, instead of getting 3 shots, we're getting 6 shots. And at ballistic skill 4, we need to double those shots in order to get, you know, 3 reliably. So if you stay still, you're firing twice. If you move, you are not firing at a reduced ballistic skill, which is really good. Overall, that means that this guy is really going to be able to dish out a lot of firepower really quickly. The reason why I think the rupture cannon is probably the better option compared to acid spray, even though the acid spray is really versatile, can deal a lot of damage, is just because of these two rules here. With the acid spray, you are not going to get a full 5 turns of shooting it in, most likely. Unless someone deep strikes on top of you, something like that, the acid spray is going to be a little bit more difficult to implement. Whereas the rupture cannon, you are going to be able to fire that turn 1, no problem, and you're not going to have to you're probably not going to have to move if you want to use it. Acid spray, you have to move, so you're giving up that ability to fire twice, and for the rupture cannon, you don't have to do that. So you are getting, you know, at least one more round of shooting in terms of not having to move, but then double that. So you're getting in between 1 and 3 more volleys off just because you don't have to move turn 1 in the first place. So I think that's a really valuable thing. And because of that, I think the rupture cannon is a winner. Acid spray, if you're able to deploy it in a way that you can reach the enemy reliably right off the bat, if they deploy right across you, then having the acid spray can actually be fairly good, especially in circumstances where you hold your Turbogon to be the very last thing, or Tyrannofex to be the very last thing you deploy. You can deploy it in response to everything else and put him just right across the table from something that you wanna really hurt. So the acid spray in that instance can be a better option, I suppose, because it does have 18-inch range. Most flamers clearly don't have that. This guy, 18-inch range, that's really formidable. Being able to automatically hit at 18-inch range, you ignore the fact that he's only ballistic skill 4, so you don't care. And having that ability to reliably put out, you know, 14 hits at strength 7 minus 1 AP D3 damage is really good. So again, if you're able to deploy it in a way, if you're able to take advantage of an enemy deployment and position this guy so he can start using the acid spray immediately, it'll be good. But if you're looking for something a little bit more flexible, then the rupture cannon is the way to go. So that's what I think. We have to talk about which Hive Fleets it should be. And I think that's pretty obvious that this should be Kronos. Unless you're taking the acid spray, then it doesn't really... Then you could go with something else. You could go with Jormungandr is probably a good choice because it gives him cover. But for things that are taking a rupture cannon, you probably want to go with Kraken because it allows, not Kraken, Kronos. Guys, I'm having a hard time here. Kronos. We want to use Kronos because it's going to allow you to reroll those ones to hit. And again, give you probably on average about one more hit if you're firing twice. So instead of getting 3, you're going to get 4 hits on average with a Kronos Tyrannofex with a rupture cannon. you're taking acid spray, of course, you don't have to reroll ones to hit. So have fun with your cover and your Jormungandr. But yeah, so that's what I think. Let me know what you think in the comments below, and of course, happy wargaming.